Hi guys, I'm Martin 50 Cal Stapleton. I'm here with Antonio Sheldon. We're here at Full Contact Performance Centre, where I'm the head MMA coach. In a previous video, we talked about the differences in level changing and the differences in range between mixed martial arts, the striking you will see in mixed martial arts, and the striking you will see in boxing, Muay Thai, K1, or any other combat sport that involves striking. And today, what we're going to do is use those same kind of principles and apply them to when an opponent is retreating. So we have to close the distance moving forward. Now, if you watch MMA, you watch a lot of UFC, Bellator, Cage Warriors, whatever, I think you'll find that maybe 75-80% of the time when people are throwing shots, they're having to close the distance. Whereas in a traditional Thai boxing match, for instance, you might see two people stood on a similar kind of spot, light on the toes. You don't really get that in MMA because of the threat of a takedown. Like if Antonio was to stand there in a Thai boxing stance, light on his front foot or whatever, my takedown becomes 10 times easier. Very similar, if you're watching a boxing match, you'll see guys stood at arms range, and you'll see a lot of rolling and slipping off to the side, creating angles, Lomachenko style, yeah? Again, you don't see that so much in MMA. You do see it now and again, but you don't see it so much in MMA because of the threat of the takedown. A lot of the time in MMA, when you are throwing your shots, you are forced to cover the distance because your opponent will retreat and move back. So today we're going to throw three different shots to start with and then three different finishes on them shots. Alright, so the first shot we're going to throw is the shovel shot to the body. I'll show it static and then I'm going to show it how we move forward and cover the distance here. So like we showed in the last video, I'm going to be level changing all the time. Getting Ando to react to the level changes. When he reacts, putting the shovel shot in just underneath into the ribcage. Now that's all well and good if Ando stands still, but like we've just described, in MMA a lot of the time that's not the case. So if Ando does start to move back as I'm throwing the shovel shot, I'm going to shift with my rear leg as I throw the rear shovel shot. I'm going to look to get my rear foot outside of Ando's foot. Alright, so I'll show the shovel shot on its own to start with. Move back first. If you look at pay attention to the foot placement, guys, as I'm shifting inwards, I'm making sure this foot gets on the outside. Very important for my angle. If this foot was to finish on the inside, my line of attack is over here, Ando's is straight forward to me, and I'm in trouble. If I land this with my foot on the outside, the opposite can be said. It's pretty easy for me to land shots off to one side with my head off the centre now, but it's very hard for Ando to do that. Show that technique again. I'm level changing, I'm getting reactions out of him. Shift in with your foot. Slightly just outside of his lead foot. Second shot I'm going to shift with is the cross. I'm going to do exactly the same. I'm going to level change, throw the cross to the body, shift with the rear leg. Throw the cross to the head as well. And again, my foot is landing outside of his lead leg. The last shot we're going to shift with is going to be the shovel shot with the lead hand. This one will throw a little bit different. So when I'm going to throw this lead hand shovel shot, I'm looking to get under the ribcage. But again, Ando's going to be moving backwards. So the way I set this up is with the 1-2 to the head, first of all. So I get my 1-2 to the head going. So that Ando's reaction is to guide the, block the head, look for the shots coming out. Once I'm getting that reaction, I'm going to drop the cross. So I'll break this down into two steps. So first step, I'm throwing the 1-2. 1-2. Obviously from this stance, I'm not going to land the shovel shot. So I've got to close the distance. The second step, I drop the cross. So I hit my jab, I rotate my hip as if I'm going to throw the shot. I just use this to shift my weight. Step one was a cross, 1-2. Step two, I'm going to go here and I just shift my weight. Now you can see as I've done that, I've still rotated my shoulder to make it look to Ando as if the cross is coming. because I want his hands up, I want him to protect his head, and I want it also to slow his backwards movement down a little bit. I've also dropped my weight nice and low on this side of his body. Going 1-2 to the head. Second time, I'm going 1-2. My weight's loading up down here now. So when I throw a shovel shot, I can rotate with a lot of power. I get all my body weight, all my hips behind it. As opposed to throwing the shovel shot from arm's distance, here, hard to land. So again, I'll show the first step, the second step, and then I'll show the third step with the shovel shot involved. First step, I'm just throwing the 1-2 to the head, getting the reaction out of him. Second step, I drop the cross, I shuffle in. Third step, put the shuffle hook in. Put all of them together now. So same shots from the opposite side, the details are exactly the same guys, we're just showing it from a different angle. We start off with the shovel hook to the body, and again I'm shifting. As I throw the rear shovel hook, I'm shifting my rear foot to the outside of Ando's leg. Stepping outside of his line of fire. All right guys. Second shot, I'm going to shuffle with, I'm going to shift with my either cross to the body or cross to the head. Covering that distance there, getting outside of his line of fire. Getting the foot outside. The third shot, more detailed one, is where I'm shifting with my cross. So I set up the cross to the head, jab cross, getting Ando's hands up, getting that reaction out of him. When I want to penetrate and get the shovel shot underneath his ribcage, jabbing, stepping with the fake cross all the way across here. I'm off the centre line, so his shots are, the only shot he's got really available to me now is a left hook. So I'm going to make sure that this is up nice and tight. This is where I land my shovel shot here. So again, I set that up in stages. Start with a 1-2 to the head to lift the hands up. Once I've got that reaction, shifting, keeping my hand up. You can see I'm in position now to land that shot. So all three stages. Okay, again guys, everything we're doing today in these drills is live drilling. So it's not just about me throwing shots in a set sequence. It's about me judging the reactions that my opponent's giving me, being able to throw the shot with the right shot at the right time with the right reaction. So what I'm gonna do now is put all them shots together and a little live drill. Me and Ando are gonna be facing each other. I'm gonna be level changing the whole time to make it easier for me to land my shots. I'm going to be asking my opponent to be moving backwards, so I've got to close the distance. I can throw any of them shots, I can go shovel shot on with the rear arm, shovel shot the lead arm, or I can use my cross to the head or the body, all the time shifting in as I do so. I'll do the same drill from the outside. And you can see that I'm shifting in, I'm covering deep distance, I'm getting right outside his lead leg every time, guys. Okay, so finally guys, we're going to finish these combos off with some high kicks. Alright, let's just recap that every time I've took this shift in here with the looking for the shovel shot off the rear hand or the cross off the rear hand. I've shifted just outside of his front foot. All right, guys. That's loading my rear leg up for the kick, especially if we're doing this dynamically and Ando's moving backwards as I'm making this step. Leads quite nicely into the kick from my left side. It was my front foot, because I've shifted, it's now my rear foot and it's loaded up quite nicely in that straight line. So we'll start off with a level change, shovel shot to the body as I shift and come to the head with the left high kick. I'm moving around, I'm level changing, getting the reactions out of Ando. Step in, shovel shot, finish, head kick. So I've come head, level change to the body, come back to the head with the kick. And again. Do the same from the opposite side, guys. And from this angle, you should be able to see how I've got this up, foot outside, big target for the left leg bit. And again, you can see the distance that's getting covered there, guys. And that because I'm stepping that foot outside, as I'm throwing that lead, this kick up to the head here, there's a lot of weight in that leg. Not a lot of power needs to be thrown, because the distance travelled will like multiply as the shot gets thrown. So I'm going to throw the exact same head kick from the left leg after I've thrown the cross now. So again, as a quick recap there, as I'm throwing my cross, it could be to the body or to the head. Ando's retreating, I'm going to shift, I'm going to take a little step, make sure I'm outside of his lead leg. He's moving backwards, I shift in, outside that lead leg, open up the head kick from the opposite side. I like to go to the body, then come back up to the head with the kick. There's nothing to stop you going to the head, then to the body, or head, then head, or body, then body. It's all down to your style. And again, guys, while you're watching that, if you rewind and pay attention to the foot placement, it's going just outside of his lead leg. Each time loaded up this left kick. We'll do it from the other side. A little shift in, stepping outside of his lead leg. Okay, guys, so the last one we're going to throw is the pendulum kick, and this is going to be off the shovel hook to the body when we've shifted in with our weight, but I haven't switched stances this time. So if you remember on the last few shots, I was switching stances as I went. This one is the one where I fake the cross, shift with the shot. So I'm still in an orthodox stance here. So again, I set this shot up by going to the head with a 1-2. Pop, pop. Now I shift with the cross. I jab, shift with it. Opens up my shot for the shovel. Ando's still retreating at this point. I take a little pendulum step, kick to the head. The pendulum step is very important, because if I don't do the pendulum step, the head kick's gonna miss. So I'm just gonna show you the wrong way to do it, and then we'll go back to the right way. So again, I've set up with 1-2 to the head. This time I jab, fake the cross, step in. Get the pendulum, get the shovel shot, Ando moves back, I don't pendulum, I'm gonna miss. The pendulum step's very important, I'm bringing heel to heel. Bringing the leg up. Like this, guys. A couple of times, about 50% speed. Notice the pendulum step, guys, one more time. And from the opposite stance. So we get a set start, setting up with the 1-2 to the head. Now I miss the cross and I get nice and deep step with it. Boom. Body shot, pendulum on my feet, kicks the head. A couple of times about 50% speed. Okay guys, and finally, as we keep saying, this is a live drill. So we're gonna put all that together now. Again, Ando's gonna be a good training partner for me. He's gonna keep moving backwards for me, retreating, so I can practice this like closing the distance with my shots. Now I'm gonna put any of them shots together. I'll be level changing so I can gauge his reactions. As I'm level changing, when I see what the target that I want, shift with the cross, shift with the shovel shot, I'll shift my weight with the fake cross. All right, guys, we'll go a couple of times through this drill, maybe 40, 50% speed. Again, it's about reactions, it's about timing. From the opposite side. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching the video. If you want to learn any more about what we're doing up here at Full Contact Performance Centre, go to www.fullcontactperformance.co.uk. Tune in to Warrior Collective for any more videos.